John Righten is an author and he's having a show based on his books and experiences, and it's all for a good cause. John, hello.
Hello.
Let's start with the cause. Who are you helping?
On the 15th of October, I'm doing a show and it is in aid of the NSPCC.
Right.
A charity that needs help now more than ever, particularly under the COVID crisis, when a lot of the money that was previously donated, times are tight for people. So I thought this show might be an opportunity to raise a little bit more money for their superb work.
Okay. And the show itself is really a talk in which you go through some incredible experiences that you've been through. Tell me a little bit about your background and what the show is about.
My background is very much is that I was raised on an estate, met some interesting characters, roguish characters. And years later, I found myself helping out in terms of aid convoys, medical aid convoys, originally into Romania. A difficult time, in terms of what was happening there with the abuse of young children. And I put together teams, and that really based in terms of my background on the estates, got some people who are roguish characters to help get these supplies through. And later on, because of what I'd learnt then, I was asked to help in for a number of charities where they couldn't get the aid through, to help get those convoys through or trucks, which were urgently needed, and would again help in terms of getting teams together. And that was, into Bosnia during the war and later on into South America.
So you've been obviously all over, in many parts of the world, meeting some incredible people, being in dangerous situations, no doubt, being probably scared on many occasions. You are a bit of a rogue character yourself. I mean, I suppose you have to be in order to get your way with a variety of people. Would you say that, or am I just insulting you here?
No. In my world, that's a compliment.
Right.
The roguish element was important because if you did things entirely through the books, what we found out is that if you did it by the book, a lot of the times you couldn't get the aid through. And I remember one particular incident where I was on my first one, I was trying to get some aid across a border. And there were six lorries that had come from Germany. And at the last moment, we were all told that we couldn't get through because we needed a stamp. All those six lorries contained a lot of insulin, antibiotics. They all turned around and went back. And we thought that was one of the saddest things I'd ever seen. And I thought, we're not turning back. So we made camp on the border. And said, we're not turning back
so
until we get this through. And, had guns held to our heads and all sorts of things. But we weren't moving. But we got it through.
You got it.
And there has to be that element, because you've got to think about, this is not about the bureaucracy. This is about trying to help the people that you set out, in terms of all this aid. And that had given you all this.
And you've written a number of books about, loosely based on your experiences.
Yes.
There's one there. Would you like to show it to the camera?
This is Heartbreak. This is my latest book.
Uh-huh.
It's just been shortlisted for the Page Turner Award, which is great. Really, really flattered by that. And this was based on a character who does one of these convoys. But it's a woman. And it's that kind of different perspective that you get from a female lead, that very much from a male lead, and certainly my own experience, that a lot of things went wrong because it was like we were, being male, clouded by ego, testosterone, all sorts of things. For the women who did that work, much more in terms of the focus of really what are we trying to do. So this is a story, it's a thriller, it's been really popular, and the follow-up, Resilience, is out next month.
Wow, congratulations. Right, so if anyone wants to obviously buy your books, they can find you on Amazon, I guess.
Everything is on Amazon. And I've even got a little book that I did for those who want to get into publishing, self-publishing, and also how to deal with criticism. And it's called The Pain of Rejection.
Right.
And it's a short little book. And every 3 months, I'm able to negotiate that it goes out for free. So if anyone wants to be able to write, for live your dreams, then have a look at that book and you can get that for free.
Wonderful. And just very quickly, again, the details of the show.
The show is on the 15th of October. And my thanks to Cliff and Tammy for their brilliant work. And it's going to be at the Carolina Brunswick. But it's going to be live streamed. So no audience. I'm going to do it live because I think with all the things I do, it needs that bit of an edge. Something could go wrong. And, you'll be able to witness that if you get a ticket. And tickets are available, £5 for the Brighton Fringe. And as I say, even if it goes wrong, it's for a really good cause.
Absolutely. John, thank you so much.
And thank you. Thank